7 days ago, I have made a video that if minus 1 power 2 is equal to 1, then minus 1 power 3, it is not equal to minus 1, because minus 1 power 3, it is equal to minus 1 power 3 is 2 times 3 by 2, and x power a times b, it is equal to x power a whole power b. So it will be minus 1 power 2 whole power 3 by 2, and minus 1 power 2 is 1 power 3 by 2, that is equal to 1. So many of you was saying that 1 power 3 by 2, it is plus minus 1. So from here, we have 1 power 3 by 2, and it is equal to 1 power 3 by 2, and 1 can be written as 1 power 2 by 3, power 3 by 2, and it will be equal to 1 power 2 by 3 times 3 by 2, and 2 will get cancelled and 3 will get cancelled. So it is 1 power 1, that will be 1. So my question was, is this step correct or not? That means x power a whole power b, it is equal to x power a times b or not? So x power a whole power b, it is equal to, according to the definition, x power a, it can be written as e power a ln x. So x power a is e power a ln x power b. Now it is x power a type, so it will be equal to e power, and a is b ln, and x is e power a ln x, and ln of any number g, it is equal to ln mod g plus iota times argument of g, where it is g, and this is real axis and this is imaginary axis, and mod g, it is distance of g from origin, and if this angle is theta, then argument of g, it is equal to theta. And if g is real, then argument of g, it will be equal to 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, and so on. So it will be 2 n pi. So ln e power a ln x, ln e power a ln x, it will be equal to ln mod e power a ln x plus iota times and argument of e power a ln x will be 2n pi and ln mod e power a ln x will be a ln x plus iota times 2n pi and x power a whole power b, it is equal to e power b ln e power a ln x x power a whole power b, it is equal to e power b ln e power a ln x and x power a power b is equal to e power b and ln e power a ln x, it is a ln x plus iota 2n pi. It is a ln x plus iota 2n pi. And x power a whole power b, it is equal to e power b times a ln x will be a b ln x plus b times iota 2n pi will be iota b 2n pi and x power a plus b is equal to x power a times x power b. So x power a whole power b will be equal to e power a b ln x times e power iota b 2n pi. And x power a is equal to e power a ln x. So x power a b will be equal to e power a b ln x. So x power a whole power b, it will be equal to e power a b ln x will be x power a b times e power iota b 2n pi. And also e power iota theta, it is equal to cos theta plus iota sin theta. So x power a whole power b, it will be equal to x power a b times e power iota b 2n pi will be cos b 2n pi plus iota sin b 2n pi. And from here n is integer. So n is integer. And now if b is integer, then x power a whole power b, it will be equal to x power a b times and cos integer multiple of 2n pi will be 1 plus iota, and sin integer multiple of 2n pi will be 0. So it is equal to x power a b times 1 plus 0, that will be x power a b. So x power a 1 power b, it is equal to x power a b if b is integer. Now we have 1 power 2 by 3 whole power 3 by 2. We have 1 power 2 by 3 whole power 3 by 2. And x power a whole power b, it is equal to x power a times b times cos b 2n pi plus iota sin b 2n pi, where n is integer. So 1 power 2 by 3 whole power 3 by 2, it will be equal to 1 power 2 by 3 times 3 by 2 times cos, and b is 3 by 2 times 2n pi plus iota sin b is 3 by 2 times 2n pi. And 2 will get cancelled, 3 will get cancelled. So it is equal to 1 power 1 times cos, and 2 will get cancelled. So it is 3n pi plus iota sin 3n pi. And 1 power 1 is 1, so it is cos 3n pi plus iota sin 3n pi. And sin 3n pi, it is always 0, and cos 3n pi, it is 1 and minus 1, because cos 3 pi is minus 1, cos 6 pi is 1, and again cos 9 pi will be minus 1, cos 2n pi will be 1, and so on. And sin 3 pi is 0, sin 6 pi is 0, it is always 0. So it is equal to 1 and minus 1. And now why we are getting two values? Because LNG, it is multi-valued function. For example, if x is minus 1, then x square will be minus 1 square, and x square will be 1, and from here x will be 1 and minus 1, where minus 1 is correct solution because x is minus 1, but 1 is extra solution. So from here we are getting 1 and minus 1, and minus 1 is correct solution and 1 is extra solution. So it is equal to minus 1.